Good morning, dear children. Let us continue the lesson acid, bases and salts. Okay, in today's class we can discuss about how acids and bases are related to our everyday life. Okay, acids and bases in everyday life. First we can see to decay. Okay, to decay. If after taking food, if you are not properly clean your mouth, the food particles, they remain in the mouth. Often it contains sugar. Okay, so the bacteria present in the mouth that feed on this sugar and produces weak acids. It produces weak acids. Okay, suppose if you are not kept your teeth clean, the acid produced by this bacteria can damage our teeth and gums. Also, these acids can make cavity on the tooth. Okay, that is about the tooth decay. Okay, the food particles that remain in the mouth actually often contains sugar, and the bacteria present in the mouth that feed on this sugar and produces weak acids. Okay, and these weak acids can cause damage to our teeth and gums if we are not kept our teeth cleaned. Also, these acids can cause make cavity in the teeth. Okay, so we should properly clean our mouth and teeth. The next is the rainwater is actually slightly acidic. The rainwater is slightly acidic. Okay, you know, the rainwater is slightly acidic in nature. You know, actually the carbon dioxide that present in air, okay, actually it dissolves in water, it produces mild carbonic acid. Okay, actually you know, the carbon dioxide that present in air, actually it dissolves in water and it produces mild carbonic acid. Actually it is a weak acid. Okay, carbonic acid is a weak acid. Okay, and we already learned in previous classes that the important property of acids. Acids are corrosive in nature. Acids are corrosive in nature because it can cause destruction to many things. Okay, and here even though the weak acids are corrosive, even though this carbonic acid is a weak acid, it can cause corrosion. Okay, and here the rainwater is being slightly acidic, actually it causes permanent damages to sculptures. Okay, it can cause permanent damages to sculptures. Also, many of our historical monuments have been damaged due to exposure to rain for many years. Okay, many of our historical monuments have been damaged due to exposure to rain for many years. For the best example is actually Taj Mahal. Okay, actually where the white marble that turned to yellow due to this acidicity of rainwater. Okay, and the next is neutralization. Okay, the next is neutralization. Okay, you know, when an acid that reacts with the base, you'll get salt and water. That is acid plus base, that will give salt and water. Actually this process is called the neutralization reaction. Okay, what is mean by neutralization reaction? When an acid reacts with the base, we'll get salt and water, and this process is called the neutralization reaction. When an acid that reacts with the base produces salt and water, this process is called the neutralization reaction. As a result of this neutralization reaction, the acid that loses its acidity, okay, and base that lost its alkalinity. Okay, due to neutralization process, the acid that loses its acidic nature, and the base that loses its alkalinity. So we get a neutral solution. Okay, as a result of neutralization process, a neutral solution is obtained. Okay, but this neutralization reaction, when an acid reacts with the base, it will get salt and water. And this process is called a neutralization reaction. And due to neutralization reaction, the acid that loses its acidic nature and base that loses its alkalinity, and we will get a neutral reaction. Sorry, we will get a neutral solution. Okay. Okay, let's see some uses of this neutralization reactions. Okay, what are the uses of neutralization reactions? The first is many of the industrial chemical process actually involve this neutralization reaction. Okay, many of the industrial chemical process involves the neutralization reactions. Also, the neutralization reaction is used to treat the industrial liquid base that is acidic or basic nature. Okay, the second is the neutralization reactions are used to treat the industrial liquid waste that is acidic or basic in nature. Also, this it is used to change in the suppose if the soil is acidic or basic, with the help of this neutralization reaction, we can convert it into a neutral soil. Okay. The neutralization reactions are useful in changing acidic or basic soil to a neutral soil, because plants do not grow in highly acidic or basic soil. Okay, these are the important uses of neutralization reaction. Many of the industrial chemical process involve the neutralization process. Also, the neutralization reactions are used to treat industrial liquid waste that is actually acidic or basic nature. Also, it is useful in changing acidic or basic soil into a neutral soil, because plants do not grow in highly acidic or basic soil. Apart from the above said uses, the neutralization reaction has also certain important applications. Okay. The first is indigestion. You know, our stomach that secretes hydrochloric acid. Okay, our stomach actually secretes hydrochloric acid. You know the function of hydrochloric acid in the stomach? Actually, it helps in the digestion of food. Hydrochloric acid helps in the digestion of food. Okay, suppose if the hydrochloric acids that accumulates in the stomach, actually it develops a severe stomach acid. Okay, suppose if the hydrochloric acid that accumulates in the stomach, actually it causes severe stomach acid. Okay, and if the pain actually it decreases, if that person is take tablets actually that contains bases such as aluminium hydroxide, and the magnesium hydroxide. Okay, so in the stomach, an excess amount of hydrochloric acid is there, and due to this, actually stomach acid happened. And when that person takes the tablets that contains base such as aluminium hydroxide and magnesium hydroxide, actually what happening here is, actually here the base that reacts with the acid and it gets neutralized. Okay, so the actually due to this, that pain gets decreases. Okay, and that is one of the important application of this neutralization reaction. Okay, you know, our stomach that secretes hydrochloric acid, actually the hydrochloric acid that helps in the digestion of food. Suppose if the hydrochloric acid that accumulates in the stomach, that leads to stomach acid. Okay, and if the pain that will subsides only if that person take the tablets that contains the base such as aluminium hydroxide or the magnesium hydroxide. Okay, and here comes the importance of this neutralization reaction. Here the base that reacts with the acid and get neutralized. Okay, so the pain that gets subsides. Okay, or get decreases. Okay. The next use is insect bites. Insect bites. Suppose the insects such as bee or wasp bites, actually that stings contain acid. Okay, actually it is very painful due to the presence of an acid, formic acid. Okay, the bee or wasp stings that actually contain the acid, formic acid. So there's such stings that should be treated with ammonia solution or calamine solution. Okay, and such solution actually that contains zinc carbonate, which is a base. Zinc carbonate, which is a base. Okay, suppose the insect such as bee or wasp bites the stings that contain an acid, that is the formic acid, and which is very painful. Okay, that stings are very painful because it contains acid, formic acid. So the bee and wasp sting that should be treated with ammonia solution or calamine solution, and these solutions actually contain the base zinc carbonate. So here the formic acid that reacts with the zinc carbonate, that is the base. Okay, and that is the importance of neutralization reaction here. Okay, and here the zinc carbonate, that base that reacts with the acid, formic acid. Okay, and that is the importance of neutralization reaction here. The next is protecting teeth. Protecting teeth. You know, actually the bacteria that present in the mouth that feed on sugar particles and produces weak acid, which can damage our teeth. That already we learned. Okay, the bacteria present in the mouth that feed on sugar particles and which can produce weak acids, which can cause damage to our teeth. Okay, and one of the common application of neutralization of acid is the toothpaste. Okay, actually here the toothpaste that contain base. Okay, and which react with this weak acid. Okay, thus we can prevent the tooth damage. Okay, and here the neutralization of base that contained in the toothpaste with the acid that produced by the bacteria. Okay, so here the neutralization, due to the neutralization reaction, we can prevent tooth damage. Okay, the bacteria that present in the mouth that feed on sugar particles, sugar in the food particles, and produces weak acids, which can cause damage to our teeth. Okay, then how we can prevent this damage? By applying toothpaste. And this actually the toothpaste which contain base. Okay, and this base that react with the water, that react with the acid produced by bacteria. And we can prevent tooth decay or tooth damage. Okay. The next is soil treatment. Soil treatment. Okay, the plants grow well in neutral soil. If the soil is too acidic or too alkaline, it is not suitable for plants' growth. So, chemicals should be added to the soil to make neutral. Okay, the plants grow well in neutral soil, and it cannot grow well when it is too alkaline or too acidic. So, we should add chemicals to the soil to make neutral. Okay, suppose if the soil is too acidic, we should add chemicals such as quick lime. Actually, which is calcium oxide, or slaker lime, which is calcium hydroxide. Okay, actually these are bases. Okay, if the soil is too acidic, we should add chemicals that contain bases as quick lime. Actually, which is calcium hydroxide, or we can add slaker lime. Okay, we can add quick lime or slaker lime to make the soil neutral. Okay, actually quick lime is calcium oxide and slaker lime is calcium hydroxide. And if the soil is too basic, we should add organic manure. Okay, if the soil is too basic, we should add what? Organic manure. Actually, organic manure contains acids. Okay, and here the acid that react with the base and we get neutral soil. Okay, that is the importance of neutralization reaction in the case of soil treatment. You know, plants that grow well in neutral solution, if the soil is too acidic or too alkaline, it is not suitable for plants' growth. So we should make the soil neutral. Okay, and if the soil is too acidic, we can add chemicals that contains bases such as quicklime or slake lime. And if the soil is too basic, we can add chemical manure. Okay, actually this manure contains acids which react with the bases, so we get a neutral solution. That is the importance of neutralization reaction in soil treatment. The next is factory wastes. Factory waste. Many industries that produce acid as waste. Suppose if it is released in land, the acids that pollute the land and also it kill soil organisms and plants. Okay, and if it is released on water, what happens? It pollutes water and also kill the organisms that lives on water and plants. That means it affects aquatic animals and plants. Okay, so in order to reduce the ill effects of this acid base, it should be neutralized before it is released into the environment. Okay, the most of the industrial waste that contains for the acid. Okay, suppose if it is released on land, actually it pollute the land and also kill soil organisms and plants. Suppose if it is released in water, what happens? It pollutes water bodies. Okay, and also it affects the aquatic animals and plants. So, in order to reduce the ill effects of this acid waste, we have to neutralize before it is released into the environment. Okay, that is about the factory waste. So, what are the things that we have learned today? We learned how acids and bases, they are related to our everyday life. Then we have learned neutralization reaction. What is neutralization reaction? When an acid that reacts with the base, we got salt and water. This process is called the neutralization reaction. Then we have learned the important applications of different applications of this neutralization reaction. Okay, that is the end of today's class. Also, we have finished that chapter. Thank you, children.